Okay, hello everybody. I hope all of you are doing fabulous, fantastic, and everything good, good. Okay, so today somebody really, really very senior. I mean, not age-wise, I'm saying, of course, he's senior, but yes, somebody I really looked up to all my career. Like when I was the journalist in CNN IBN, you know how newsrooms are. They're not very happy space to be in. But here was a man with a team who were the happiest lot. Bunch of people in entire newsroom, entire office. So any problem and every problem he had solutions, like, and literally he started his own company with the name of HR Solutions. So simply HR and all kind of solutions. So he is somebody I really admire for whatever he stands for. And he's an amazing human being. And I think if I have to talk about him, I can go on and on. So let me cut it short. You will get to know more about him. So let me invite Rajni Singh, sir. Okay, Rajni, sir, if you can switch on your camera.
Hi, Divya. Hi.
Hello, sir. So it was amazing to connect with you after so many years. I don't know what prompted me. And when I started Radio Diva, it just prompted me ki maybe he will like what I'm doing. So let me just get in touch with him. And I did. And you were kind enough to oblige and to tolerate the hangama that happens on the group every all. So how are you, sir? And how's everything so far?
Touch wood, so far so good. Divya, thank you for having me over. It's absolute pleasure to be with you.
Thank you so much, sir. Sir, okay, let me start with something. You were heading Network 18 ka entire HR department when I was working. And I'm talking about 10 years back. After that, you founded your own company, right? And you have seen success like anything. So give me that those tips which a person like me will really need it.
After having served in corporate for close to 22 years, we decided to take the plunge and start our own HR company, Simply HR Solutions. And in these 10 years, I think I wouldn't say we are super successful, but are we a happy lot, which you talked about in the introduction also that, you know, it was a very happy team back in Network 18. I think that that has remained the mantra as to how do you keep your team happy. I think the moment you are able to do that, magic happens. So I've always believed in the power of teamwork. I was very, very happy, privileged to have got a very good partners team. So we are four partners who run the firm. All ex-colleagues from Network 18, and a lot of Network 18 people would know them. And then, of course, the team that came along and few people from Network 18 also joined us. So I think overall, it's been the entire team that has brought us here. So all thanks to their effort, you know, the kind of work they have done so far. We have been able to establish ourselves in the market. People know about us. End of the day, it's been hard work, commitment, and just ensuring that the client is happy at the end of the day. So that those are the things that we have ensured in these 10 years.
Wow, that's wonderful. But itna lamba, like na, the association that you had with your colleagues has gone like really, it's a long journey that you have all covered together. So how, I mean, I would personally love to know the secret behind keeping everybody together. That like for many, it's a humongous job to.
I think, together. Yeah. So that, correct. No, trust me. I mean, managing people, leading people is one of the toughest jobs that one can have. It was definitely very, very important for me to ensure that the team, especially at the partner level, stays retained. And it was my personal kind of interest and the time that I would spend with the partners team month on month, at times on a weekly basis, at times on a daily basis, to ensure that the leadership team is intact. So if, like I mentioned, all my partner colleagues are from Network 18, so our relationship now goes back almost 15 years. You know, so we have stayed together. And I believe very strongly anybody starting up on their own to have like-minded people join together to start a venture. I think that is very, very important. So I think the set of values that all four of us carry, that binds us. The kind of time that one has spent with them on a very regular basis, all that has really helped in keep going.
Right. That's amazing. So, you know, that brings me to the question ki many people are, you know, startups are the like present vogue or whatever you want to call it. Like, it's so much as everybody is into startups these days. Everybody wants to be their own boss. So, what will you like to tell all the people who are starting up and they really want to make it big and be their own bosses? Because startups jitni jaldi like they are starting, they are finishing off also at that rapid speed. So what would be your advice to startups?
The startup community will only grow now in the country, even globally, I would say, purely because of the kind of situation we have all been through. Jobs are going to really narrow down. So which means that you will need to become a job creator rather than a job seeker. And that is the beauty of starting something of your own.
Mm-hmm.
So the more...
So there is a network issue, I think, at your end.
Look around them, that can be, those are the ideas people need to look out for.
There is a network issue, sir.
Sure.
Go ahead, sir.
Yeah, so what I was saying was that in given the situation that we are in, we need more job creators rather than job seekers, as jobs really narrow up all around us. So it will become very, very important for youngsters to really identify some problems around them, build up ideas around that as solutions, and really then create organizations around that. You know, so and for that, I think it will be very, very important, of course, will be the whole financial part of it, whether you get enough funding for your idea. And also then hiring the right people, starting up with the right team, all that becomes very important. I, being a HR person, I would overemphasize that do create a culture of openness, of inclusiveness, where people really enjoy working. So those are some of the things that I would strongly recommend for young people who want to be on their own.
You know, many businesses are going through a lot. Like, I know many people personally who are, because this situation was very unexpected. People had made plans. I mean, so for example, I stay in Noida, and there is a small mall nearby, and there is a Oxford, if you know Oxford Chabar, which is in CP. So a bunch of Oxford has opened, and I was like super excited.
Yeah.
I think March it opened and March it closed also because pandemic came. So I was just wondering, you know, throughout last 8 months, I was wondering how they might be surviving. So many people would have just started their business or done some big like investment, and they must be facing so many issues right now. So what do you have to tell to business people who are facing these issues right now?
I think in this whole situation, the smaller business people definitely have been hit the most hard. I mean, very clearly for them, they just about could survive for maybe first 2-3 months of lockdown. But then they just couldn't pay salaries. And then, of course, they just started cutting jobs as well. So it's been hard on small business people, on traders, essentially, for whom, it's like a day in, day out cash business. And once the cash dries out, all your savings dry out, then you are left with nothing. And that's where we have really seen many people not only shutting down, but also, just ending their life also. I mean, that's been the tragedy, not only taking their own life, they have taken life of their entire family because they just couldn't take on the debt or the borrowings that they were doing, and they just couldn't imagine how to really repay things that they had piled up. So it's been very tough. People who have really cut down on everything and just have taken a break from running whatever business they have, and really zeroed down on whatever little survival you know things that they need. Those are the people who will probably see through this, and I am very sure some of them are going to come back. Maybe not in the same business. Maybe they'll come back with some other idea. And you know, the beauty of running a business is once you become a entrepreneur or a businessman, it is a kida, and it doesn't go away. So in spite of all the you know hardships, people do come back, and I'm very optimistic that a lot of people are going to come back stronger. And there is resilience in people. So we'll see action in some time soon.
Wow, that's wonderful. I mean, you know, when I was listening to your experience and whatever you had to share, I was like, okay, something of that measure has happened, but you like finished it on a very positive note. Yes, I'm also hoping against hope that yes, people will come out much more stronger. And I think this pandemic is a big learning for many of us. Yes, I mean, many of us took things for granted. And I think that is one lesson that we have to learn. Yes, you have to be prepared for anything and everything.
Absolutely. I think that reality has hit everybody very hard. Probably in our lives, such a disruption has never happened. So it's been a absolutely life-changing experience for many people. Many people will come out wiser, hopefully, and learn some very, very important lessons of how to lead a life, forget running businesses and doing a job.
True, very true. So coming to my favorite question, Ki, I have always seen you from afar. For me in office, I think met you or like just interacted with you for few signing like bills or something because I traveled for my shoot or something and your signatures were required. So I have seen you only that much. Let me be honest to you. Sure. I think I interacted more with all your team people than with you. But yes, I always admired the kind of cheerfulness or the liveliness you brought with yourself. And I think even when I was just looking for a photograph of yours on Facebook, that reflects that yes, you are somebody who knows how to live life. So please share your secret.
Yeah, so I think it's very important how you take life. There is burden all around. So if I just continue to focus on burden and hardships and challenges and you know, then you're going to get trapped in them only. And very soon, a lot of frustration will build up and which would lead to probably a kind of a situation of depression. And you know, whatever we are talking these days of mental health and what have you. On the other side, I think it's very, very important to look at life as an opportunity which has been given to you to make the most of, you know, this time. So it's very, very important how you spread positivity, fully knowing there are challenges all around. But I think the messaging, right from your body language to what you communicate, the way you talk, the way you write, you know, all that matters a lot. And it all starts from self. So if I am in control of myself, and if I believe that out there is more positivity than negativity, I think life really then takes a different turn altogether. And so in my life also, one has faced many, many situations, but I think it was very, very important that you stayed focused and that you wanted always to come out of situations fully knowing that no hardship or no problem situation really lasts forever, right? I think that's the message that I give to myself, that this can't last for all life. I'll not allow it to last. And I think the moment you take that mindset, apply that mindset, then it's you just come out of it, you'll find solutions, you'll find alternates, and then you just bounce back and you know, and then of course, like I said, the messaging to the outside world, whatever could be happening inside me, the whole exterior thing, what I convey outside, has to be super positive. I mean, that I've always believed, and I've seen the impact of that on people around me.
Wow, that's wonderful, because कहते हैं ना जीते सब हैं पर जीना सबको नहीं आता है ना ना everybody is alive but not everybody knows how to live.
absolutely yeah.
So this is one thing that from far you have taught me. I mean, I think I took that great step. I'm happy I took the step of just barging in and just messaging you the one fine day that yes, I'm doing something called you, yes. Diva, and please be part of it.
No, I was very happy to see what you were doing, and was keen and good that you added me into the group. I know I've been not very, very active given my schedule and all. But I think the more I see of what you're doing, the kind of community that you're building, you know, the way I see the future, a lot of community building is going to happen. And which is what I was reading about your dream for Radio Deva, that you want the housing societies, you know, to have those local kind of radio community built. Now that's future. I mean, so you're already thinking, talking about it. I mean, so the kind of stuff you're doing, especially in the times that we live in, connecting people, talking about life and spreading positivity and cheer, remarkable stuff. So I was very happy to be part of the community.
That's amazing. So last question, is there a message, you know, many of the youngsters who are like, I know this very senior friend of mine, and he has a son who was in college last year, and he was like, I don't want to stay home, I want to stay in college. So many youngsters right now who are maybe in the final years are looking for jobs, and it's not a very happy time for people who are in job and people who are not in job. So it's a very unpredictable and unforeseen situation right now that everybody is facing about their own future. So what do you want to tell all the youngsters around?
You know, again, like I talked about the businessmen, some of it I would apply on the youngsters also. They have again been hit very, very hard because of the whole uncertainty that has come in about this whole corona thing, because there is no end to it. You can't see when it's going to fold up. And that's the tragedy of the whole thing. And that is where youngsters are getting very, very anxious. There is a lot of stress in them. Therefore, they're getting very hassled. Parents are getting hassled as to what will happen of their future. My sense is again that it is a waiting game. There is no magic solution out there that anybody has, honestly. The schools, colleges themselves are struggling. They don't know whether exams are going to happen on time. People who were wanting to go abroad for studies have cancelled everything, rescheduled everything. It's been complete mess for everybody, you know. So people, like I talked about the businessmen, I think it's a time to take a complete pause and really just lie low till this whole storm really goes away. You know? And sadly, this storm can last another year, maybe a year and a half. Nobody has it. So yes, the youngsters are feeling very, very badly trapped in this whole situation. Some of them, very interestingly, and like they are so tech savvy, they have adapted to or taken up a lot of online courses to just keep themselves engaged, occupied. And someone like you also coming up with this idea as to how you connect people. My sense is youngsters, even at a school level, might come up with some brilliant business ideas, given the situation that we are, because they are also stuck at home. They don't know what to do. Maybe just 2-3 of them partner up and come up with some, maybe an app or maybe some platform. You don't know. And I think given the situation, technology is one thing that can be leveraged big time. So if people can think up some interesting ideas, even in these times while they are idle, things are moving at a pace beyond on which they don't have any control. So I feel people, the youngsters should still stay focused rather than really really feeling low about the whole situation. The mindset still has to be that there is an opportunity in this crisis out there.
Do you think this situation can be taken as an opportunity for many to hone skills and to update themselves? Like many of us, I mean, I would love to learn a language. So maybe this is the right time to do it. So, I mean, I'm playing table tennis. I've never had the time to play table tennis all my life. So I'm learning that. So, you know, there are things which we can do. Like now, I think picking up that will really help. What do you think?
Absolutely. That's what I said, that this whole crisis has to be seen more as an opportunity. Pick up on things that you always wanted to do because suddenly you have some time on hand. Pursue that, whether it is sports, whether it is music. People are making some short movies, for instance, because you can shoot movies on a phone as simple as that and you can just put together. And, you know, so people are doing some very, very interesting things. So my sense is, this is an opportunity to hone up your skills, add on to what you already have. And honestly, it's not also just restricted to youngsters. I see a lot of mid-career people taking a break from corporate forever now. And they're just doing something different, you know. They're doing online maybe coaching. They're doing online training. They've started designing courses for people on entrepreneurship. For instance, I have a good friend who started doing that. So even at a mid-level, people are getting a sense that why not do something different. So it's an interesting time when a lot of people are getting different calling of their life. And so a lot of change will happen.
Yeah, and this time has given lots of introspection time also, because many of us were like, not me, but many people were in this rat race, racing against whom, God knows. So I think that this give a break, okay, look, what, is this where you want to belong to and to be part of for the rest of your life or do something? That time was not coming that people sit back and think. So I think this has given a lot of time to people. So I think a positive and a negative both has come out of this situation.
Correct. And again, I purely because of this break, people are, there is a lot of introspection happening. Lot of, you know, people are, now that unlock has started, so interstate travel has started happening. People are still working from home. They can work from anywhere. So they're just packing bags, going up to the hills. They want to be, and the only first thing they check on a homestay or a hotel is, how's your bandwidth there? Because I want to stay connected because I'm still working. But the good part is they're just wanting to go to hills, go to some outside place away from home, be with nature, you know, where they can go for walk and probably run and yet work. That whole balance between work and life is going to take a very different meaning altogether.
True. Any last words, sir? Anything that you want to give, any you want to share with Radio Diva family?
Radio Diva family, I think I see some very, very, like I said, enterprising lot. I was listening to one of the real heroes also, with whom you've been in touch for a long, long time. Very humbling story. And I listened to him and I think you're able to connect. You've been able to bring about so many people together with very diverse background, and which is the beauty of your channel. I think you've cut across, you know, the saddest thing would have been that being a media person, you've just got media people all around you. You know? You have broken all those barriers and you've just gone across. That's something that, you know, you've challenged yourself. The whole the part about the purpose behind why you're doing this. That's so compelling, and I'm sure it's so satisfying for you. It is touching lives. I'm sure people are seeing change in themselves being part of this family. So if you're able to do that, you've done remarkable stuff for people.
That's amazing, and that's so heartening and beautiful to just hear it from you. You know, I know what I'm doing is good. Achhi feeling aati hai. But now that you get a confirmation from somebody like you, trust me, it's a great feeling.
No, I wish it all success. I was so happy when you touched the 100 days milestone. Look, the beauty of startups or doing anything of your own is about sustaining it. You know, the initial excitement is there. Everybody kicks off and starts off. But the challenge is, how do you sustain it? How do you keep the interest alive? And the other thing that you've smartly done is to keep it very dynamic. You've been with the flow of the community members, of the family members. And you've worked everything around them. And so you made it, you made them as the centerpiece, you know, that this is all about you rather than me. And that's where you've got it absolutely right. So you just got to keep it very dynamic, continuously evolving so that it stays as fresh as it can be.
Yeah, I think it's a joy to do, but it's a joy to hear it from you, sir. I'm like feeling so grateful. I can't tell you. I'm such a privilege to have you, sir.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. I will just...